is David Benton. I'm your host for this evening's program, Celebration Nightcap. I would like to take this opportunity to introduce my co-hosts, Carol Gagnon and Jerry Thuringer, my good and great friends.
For 8 days in August, Vancouver was host to Celebration 90, and what a celebration.
Come celebrate.
Where do 10,000 athletes and cultural participants eat, sleep, and how do they get around the city? How do you organize 27 sports and cultural events that range from the Commodore to the Orpheum to the Plaza of Nations?
Well, thousands of Vancouverites answered the call and welcomed participants and athletes into their homes.
Volunteers donated their time by registering athletes, by driving buses, by driving vans, by working with security and medical. Yes, through Celebration 90 staff, all events went off without a hitch.
The majority of people that are working as volunteers have never volunteered for anything in their lives before. Many people, this is their first connection with the community at all, outside of their own relationship or a night at the clubs. This is the first time they've really got involved in making a difference. And I like to think that they're going to stay involved in some way after this, that it will have a lasting effect on them.
It's definitely a team effort. We're having a good time working together, yeah. You get to meet a lot of new people that you wouldn't meet otherwise. It's great fun.
How do you feel this event's going to affect things in the future?
Well, I hope it'll just, I don't know, I hope it'll make the public more knowledgeable about our community.
Initially, it was just the board of directors and myself, and one of the first jobs was to start a volunteer base off. For the first year, there were only 50 or 60 of us starting up with the sports co-chairs. When we opened registration, there were about 1,500 volunteers, and by the end of the registration process, there were 2,755.
Basically, all the areas that have to be looked after are all the sports, all the cultural, all the operations behind the scenes things, such as setting up the medical services and the transportation, the shuttles between venues, site directors, hospitality, products, product sales, product sellers. Tickets, everything, absolutely everything that goes on in this organization is volunteer run.
When people started coming in from different countries, there was a volunteer booth where they could go and volunteer. Did a lot of them do that?
Absolutely, And roughly about 100 people pre-volunteered. They pre-registered to, from the States, from Germany, from various other countries. So that they could be involved on the days that they were not being an athlete. Some of them traveled all this way just to volunteer as well.
In June, Carol heard the call of paradise and moved to Vancouver. She became a volunteer for Celebration 90 right away. You may have seen us wandering around the streets with the t-shirts on that said Celebration 90 Volunteer Extraordinaire. Well, I can tell you, Carol really was a volunteer extraordinaire.
I really enjoyed participating in Celebration 90. with over 27 sports and activities taking place in venues in places like Langley to West Vancouver, how could one not enjoy themselves? Competition was fierce.
Attempting 305 pounds in her first squat day.
Concentrate, Donna.
Go, Donna.
It's yours. Come on, Donna. Yeah!
Yesterday I saw a button that said, I'm straight but I'm not narrow. Celebration 90 was about participation and being all inclusive. Participants ranged in age from 8 to 80. Pat Dooley and his brother Kevin and Kevin's wife are all umpires for baseball, and they umped not only for the gays but straights as well.
When you found out they wanted to officiate here at the gay games, that didn't bother you?
No, not at all. I chose the officials which I felt would be most suitable in terms of their capabilities physically and mentally for this type of event. And there were about three or four officials that I did talk to who were not interested in doing the gay games, which is fine, that's their own choice. But the fellows that I do have here, including two of my brothers, are having a great time, are being well treated. And that's the reason why I had no hesitation in taking on this assignment. There's approximately 190 assignments.
190?
Yes, yes.
So how many?
I know because I'm doing them.
So how many umpires have you got out there doing all these?
The size of the crew would be about a total of 20 officials I've used over the 5 days, 20 officials.
Put me in, coach. I'm ready to play today. Look at me. Gotta be Santa Theo. Yeah.
Jerry also heard the call of paradise and just recently moved here from Montreal. It's quite a cultural city, isn't it?
Mais c'est sûr, mon ami David. I mean, what do you expect when you have two separate cultures living in the same city? Celebration 90 not only featured athletic prowess, it also celebrated gay and lesbian arts and entertainment. Gay Pride Week coincided as well with Celebration 90 this year and helped kick off the festivities with a gala parade.
We're from Vancouver.
Yeah, what are you doing?
We're the waitresses. There she is. We're the waitresses. We're just a fun group.
Ted Rogers.
All these out of towners going to do?
Oh, I think it's great.
Excellent.
It's
wonderful.
Going to be the biggest parade we've had.
Thank you. It's amazing how everybody's come together, how things have clicked, and over a lot of the difficulties that they encountered through the last few years, they've overcome them, and Vancouver, the city, the province, the country should be very proud of the Vancouver gay community.
This should have a lasting effect on our community, do you think?
I should hope so. I think all of a sudden people realize we're not just a bunch of fairies waltzing through the park.
Imagine 35 dancers taking direction from 35 choreographers. The light from a new torch started in Boston and crossed America, touching seven cities, picking up participants all along the way, and finally arriving back here at Celebration 90 in Vancouver.
It's building on an idea that I used in 1986 for Gay Games 2. In that situation, there were three friends who were dancers with whom I had never really spent a lot of time because we lived in different cities, so I thought we'd use a creative process to increase the bond of our friendship and also learn about our different dance styles. The title came from the whole idea of the Olympic torch and the fact that the Gay Games is similar in that we're striving to be the best we can be, even as dancers. But it's a torch, and the new torch is a torch of diversity, a torch of inclusion. And that's what this dance was about, was including as many people and many ideas as possible.
Working on the tour, getting ready for Jeff and Alvin to come from the East Coast about 4 months ago. They actually arrived about 5 weeks ago in Minneapolis, in my hometown, and that was the exciting moment when we found that when we got together and we realized, yes, we can do this, we can all do this together. Our dance, which is based on principles of community building and inclusion and relations between the genders and between the races and between ages, really fit in. So I feel like there's a way in which I feel like I am coming home by being here at the Games.
Cultural events range from dance to film, art, literature, even music. Words Without Borders was a literary festival which occurred throughout the week, featuring many prominent gay and lesbian writers.
There is a peculiarity about being a Canadian writer that I think perhaps people from England and the States don't appreciate. Very few novels can be published in Canada alone. The audience is not large enough. So most of us who are fiction writers need to have publishers either in England or in the States, as well as in Canada, to survive. Back when I was first publishing, when Desert of the Heart was first published, the novel was accepted by Macmillan of Canada, but we had to wait for Secker and Warburg in England to come on side before it could be produced. Also, Canadian editions of books don't stay in print very long. So, I mean, you may have asked recently when it was broadcast, I made the Globe and Mail, I think David Wattmo was counting five times. He was a bit jealous. Because one of my books had been seized at the border. It happened to be The Young in One Another's Arms, which won the Canadian Authors Association Best Novel for 1978. And they're not exactly a radical crew. But because it was in a box of books going to a gay bookstore, it was seized along with the others. It was very useful publicity. We could mock what was going on. But you might pause and think, what is a Canadian writer doing having her books seized at the Canadian border? I mean, why are they coming into the country? Why aren't they going out? I mean, what kind of free trade deal is going on here? I have said elsewhere that it's a particular embarrassment to me. While I was teaching at UBC, I had a student who was a very personable young man, but he was obviously not really interested in university, and he was in the process of flunking English 100 under my care for the third time. And we had a nice chat, and he said he really did think he was goofing off and that probably what he ought to do is grow up and go out in the world and get a job. And I said I thought that was a good idea, too. Soon after that, he came to me with a request that I write a letter of recommendation for him. And since he was a personable and perfectly bright young man, I said, sure, I would. He was applying to be a Canada Customs official. I often think now what business have we as a literate country to put into those hands the authority to tell us what we can read and what we can't read?
Grapevine that dance wasn't going to happen during Gay Games, and I thought that would be a real shame because I think that dance is one of the most gay supportive of all the art forms. So I said, hey, it's got to happen. And so I went out to all these groups and asked them specifically for pieces that I'd seen, and much to my surprise and joy, they all said yes. And it wasn't just the gay community that said yes, everybody said yes, and they wanted to support the Gay Games.
One thing that we were thinking about with dance in particular, that really being gay or straight is never an issue. So that wouldn't even have crossed our minds, like as Emery was saying.
But Emery, you were also dancing with another group, and you were dancing with a gay woman.
Tonight.
Two gay men.
Oh my God.
You make it sound
very versatile girl here.
No, it's just, you know, friends within the community, and if they happen to be gay or not. Joe asked me to be in his piece, and I mean, I don't, you know, it's not straight like, boxes or something. I mean, we all, if you're in the arts, I think you've got to have a pretty open mind, and I don't think it's, I think everyone does.
Oh yeah, that's just the freedom of the arts, which is so nice.
I first made this piece with a friend of mine that I was working in the same dance company with me, and we were friends, but we were very competitive with one another, and we had a lot of conflict. And so as much as we loved each other, we also, you know, hated each other too. And so it was sort of a starting point for me thinking about the ways that men relate to each other or don't relate, the way they're limited by masculinity in their relationships with one another.
Never be the same, having hosted Gay Games 3 and Cultural Festival. It was a celebration like none the city has ever seen, none we've ever seen, and certainly none the participants had ever seen. We enjoyed ourselves a lot.
And we'll see you
in 1994
at Gay Games 4 in New York. Thank you for joining us. Good night.
On behalf of the organizing committee of Celebration 90, I would like to thank all you athletes and cultural participants for coming to Vancouver for this absolutely fantastic week. Thank you. It's been a week filled with pride, joyous festivities, and thousands of personal best achievements. We hope you can carry the memories of Celebration 90 with you always. Our utmost thanks and praise to the phenomenal work performed by our volunteers. Celebration 90 happened because of its volunteers, and you have made it happen. It is with great joy and honor that we hand over tonight the Gay Games flag to the Federation of Gay Games to award to the host city for Gay Games 4 in 1994. In doing so, I declare Celebration 90, Gay Games 3, and Cultural Festival officially closed. But thank you for coming, and it's been wonderful. Thank you very much.